Anyway, we're gonna be finishing Resident Evil Mortal Night tonight. Oh yeah. Hopefully, anyway. But yeah, so this is chapter 3 of a 3-chapter mod, which has been more than stellar so far. This is my first like full mod I've played. I played the demo for the mod that this mod maker is working on currently, which is called, oh no, I forgot the name of it. During the Storm, that's what it's called. But this one's called Mortal Night. Mod maker, Resident Evil Nemesis 30, as you can see down there. And yeah, it's a mod of classic Resident Evil 2, where we play as Hunk during the events of Resident Evil 2. Nightmares. Okay, good, the text is working. Unlike yesterday. Don't need to restart it or anything like that. What the? I think we're inside our own head there. Just a quick recap for anybody that wasn't around. Yesterday we had gotten to this train, met up with Sherry and Alyssa. Sherry, of course, from RE2, and Alyssa from the Outbreak series. And then we went back to go blow up Nemesis, which we had to do at point blank range for some reason. Also, we're in danger. Smile. Okay. I have a feeling we might be playing as Alyssa very soon. So Alyssa and Sherry made it to the lab. Yep. That's the we're changing character sound effect. Is everything alright, Sherry? You look strange. Rude, TBH. Yes, I'm fine, but although Evans looked like another evil guy of Umbrella, I've realized that he's just a good person doing a horrible mission. It's a shame that he had to sacrifice himself to save us. The point is that without having really met him, he gave me more security than my parents in my whole life. Oh, Sherry. The situation has let me mature. I'm more than I. What the fuck? You need me to talk? If you need to talk, just tell me. Okay, thanks. Sorry, I got lost in the grammar of that sentence. You know what's stupid? That's a default sound effect in Resident Evil 2, but every time I hear it, I think it's like Sonic. Control panel key. Can we see Mr. X? Nope. You know, we've seen a lot of Birkin in this mod. We have not seen any Mr. X. We got Nemesis. We've seen Nemesis a couple times. What are we starting with here? Oh, she has a crossbow now. Neat. Oh, I don't have a knife. Okay, well. No knifing around for us. I should have set up a command for getting the link to this mod. My apologies, everyone. Hey. Hello, Norman. How are you doing this evening? I don't need this thing right now. I bet we're fighting Birkin pretty soon. What do you have to say, Sherry? Ah. Ah, she teleported. Oh, we have to go backwards? Machine control panel. Okay. I mean, I guess we don't need to use that. Or anything down here. Well, we have the control panel key. We could just use it, right? No, hold on. Let's go over here. Just a moment. Oh. Alright. God damn it. These at channels, man. Who's this? How many keys do I need for this thing? I can't store stuff either, so I shouldn't worry about it, I guess. Why did each of them... Oh, no. Okay, I guess just that one guy had the key. I don't need this right now. Better keep this door locked. That monster could be following us. Oh, poor Hunk. He's never gonna make it. Zero faith. in hunk from the rest of the team here. Okay, I'm gonna assume that I have all the keys I need. But yes, I will go up the ladder. I like that Nemesis is just completely obliterated. Can I use this key? Aha! Like, there weren't even traces of him back in that other area. The elevator's already here. Okay. And so are the zombies. Yeah, whatever. Whatever, nerds. Wait, shit. Do I want that? Can I get that? There's like so many boxes everywhere! I know I can't get this one. Or can I? Okay. You! Okay. I don't need this thing right now. There we go. Just to make it 1% easier for Hunk. Bye, zombie. Got that sound. It always gets me. What the heck is Sherry right now? Oh, she's operating the train. Why did you go out without me? You've had luck, but you've endangered your life. You're wrong, Alyssa. My father did something. Since then, the monsters don't attack me. Never. What? Can you explain it to me? It's like if I were the queen bee of a hive. All the monsters follow me, but none of them try to hurt me. Well, I... Damn it. Wait here. I'm gonna check out what happened. I think we have a Birkin fight on our hands. Probably want the crossbow for this. Ah! It's this zombie. He's behind it all. Oh, I think I needed to climb up on that thing. Don't grab me. Hell yeah. We got baited. What's that sound? Is that a spider? That's probably a spider. That's a spider. No thanks. I must admit, I'm not terribly familiar with this this part of the game. Because this is only in, like, Claire B, right? Or maybe it's in both B scenarios? I can't remember. But it's been a while since I played a non-A scenario in original RE2. Or that's a custom area and I just didn't recognize it. The elevator's here. Where are you, Sherry? It's Davies. Hey, are you Davies? Bye. I love the damage suit. It's pretty good. Alright, you guys legally have to give me a full heal. You can't just spawn me like this. That's interesting. My knife's equipped, but I can't actually use it. Oh, yes, I can. Just undid it when it transitioned back to me. No, not you, Nemesis! fucking empty revolver. Oh god. Oh god. Go. He's gonna be in here, isn't he? No, he's gonna chase me though. I shouldn't go this way. Especially since this is a completely dead end. He's coming. We're dead. Rip. Okay, this is a waste, but if I don't do it, I'm dead. Well, okay, I'm dead. I guess I'm dead anyway. It's bullshit. Stupid narrow tunnels. I thought there'd be an item over there. What the hell? Ah, the disrespect from Nemi. Alright, well, we start over. Luckily, that was mostly cutscenes, so, you know, no big deal. I can't skip this. I skip this. I guess it's only like 1 second long, so. So I guess Nemesis just ran off while we were getting our ass kicked. I should check that other room, but that'd be weird if they spawned anything in there, right? Please let me skip this. There we go. Thank you, game. Most of the cutscenes have been skippable so far, which is why I was like, I kind of like, so in the other mods this mod creator is working on, during the storm, they have, they've given you 4 inventory slots as you're playing as another character from Outbreak, Kevin. And I'm curious how well that's going to work in the long term with that mod. Because that's a neat little touch to begin with, but I'd like to see how it plays out. Give me your key. Oh wait, no, that's this guy. This guy has the key. I didn't turn the thing on. Thank God for door skips. How are you, undead bastards? Leave me be. So one meme I've heard of with RE mods, or RE2 mods specifically, is that you don't have like iframes or anything when you're in like a cutscene. So if you put like a cutscene where like zombies are, you can totally just get attacked. Which sounds very annoying. But this mod has yet to feature any such thing. So then again, this mod's a lot less like hardcore than a lot of them. Should I try to go past those spiders? There might be something over there. I don't know. Eh, fuck it. Spooky looking spiders, huh? I'd honestly probably freak out if I saw like an albino, like gigantic spider. Well, in general, if there was a spider that was like human-sized, probably wouldn't be thrilled to see it. And yes, I know those exist. Hey, Sharp, thank you for the 7 months. How's it hanging? Alright, Nemesis, be nice. Don't slam my butt. There's really not like a ton of space between you and like being able to pick all that shit up. It's been a rough 24 hours. I'm sorry to hear it. Well, yeah. Hopefully the next 24 will treat you better. Get this loot! Get the loot! Oh god, Nemesis is right behind us. Go, go, go! I feel like it wants me to heal, but it's also a dick move. They start me off in danger, and then they give me like one green herb. Screw you, game. Also, empty gun, lol. What? What the hell? I don't know what to do now. We're about to lose again. Unless I could do this. Is there like a key over here or something? Did I miss something? Well, if it's back there, I can't go back, so... If it's on Nemesis, I have no idea how they expect me to defeat Nemesis with just a knife. That's ridiculous. Unless his gun's supposed to have ammo and just doesn't or something. But it wasn't over here. Like, we checked this corner. Oh my god, it's right here. I saw part of her post. I don't know precisely what happened. Oh, fuck. Dude, what is this? Okay. Oh, fuck. I saw that your wall got kind of busted up. Okay, we'll wait for him to come out here and then we can get past him more easily. At least I assume. Oh, wow. Oh my god. I saw people joking and like there was just a lot of chatter and I couldn't figure out what was actually going on. Damn, dude. Well, I hope you're okay. Nice meme key right there. What the heck was that? Oh, okay. Well, yeah, I mean, obviously he's still following us. Please give me the item, and let me get out of here. Oh, he's going so fast. Okay, nice. Full heal. That's nice. He's gonna be right there. Oh, he's- wait, he's in front of me? How? What? Oh my god, I'm in danger again. Please do the big punch. Yes. Well, we have no healing, but whatever. This is an intense chase sequence. Oof. Damn. Well, I'm sorry to hear that, man. Yes, activate this. Understandable. Oh, don't go outside. I want to save. Or at least put my crap away. Aw, man. I bet I can go back inside, though. Okay, cool. This game has some mercy. It at least gave me a full heal back. These guys are all moving so fast! Okay, they slowed down. Thanks. Alright, now they're fast again. Yes! Ooh, fell down in two. I know neither of you guys are dead. No, wait, that guy is dead. What the hell? This guy's not dead, though. Or he is dead, he just isn't showing a blood puddle for some reason. Okay. I doubt these guys have any items, considering there's like a million items out here, but I need to check, regardless. to what now? Converts normal ammo into enhanced ammo. Ooh, okay, okay. We'll definitely take some of that. Three of them. We don't have any ammo right now, but that'll change eventually. Oh, don't. Okay, I was like, please don't fucking bite my ankles. Hey, ammo! What do you know? I can't hold anymore. Alright, let's put normal ammo in here, I think. What in the heck? Oh, does this not use magnum rounds? Are you freaking kidding me? What is this nonsense? Oh my god. Okay. Wait, maybe this only accepts enhanced rounds or something? Power revolver, which can destroy everything you want. It fires special magnum bullets. Okay, so it wants us to merge these. Gotcha. Okay, that's less ridiculous. I know, right? Oh, more than... I have a knife. Why would I... Excuse me. Is this the super knife? Combat knife. It could come in handy. Yeah, it's the same item. It's literally the same item. Are you kidding me? It won't let me go back. Now our inventory's full again. I mean, I can whittle it down a little. Get two more slots. Oh, you brought the platform up. You have to go outside now. Cool. Very cool. Okay, there's the keys. Kind of want to save at least one of these. Oh, right. I have to actually use it. I regret picking up that knife now, in all honesty. Are we gonna have to fight Birkin? Oh, we might. Damn it. Well, we did just get, like... Oh, it's Nemesis. What the... Well, Nemi, I guess bring it. What's this? It's time to kill the proto-nemesis. Well. There goes one clip. No wonder they gave me so much ammo. Like, oh, you're gonna use it in 2 seconds, lol. No, don't do it! Unlike me, Nemesis has not had a chance to grab any herbs or spices. Don't do it! I don't like that my 10 bullets turn into 6 bullets, by the way. God. Ah, whatever. Cool. Did not take every last bullet. Game over, big boy. Why would I think that will kill him when I literally exploded him from the inside and he's just fine? Why does this look like a pickup? Whatever, hunk. At least we still have 5 bullets. Could probably have knifed him, like, I don't know, for some of that. Saved, like, a bullet. But, That fucking sound effect. I was like, please fall down. You have to after 4, right? By the way, they totally don't have to fall down after 4 swipes. Normal zombies do, though. Like, it's a max of 4, I'm pretty sure. At least in this mod, specifically. No! Damn it! Excuse me? Why were you not dead? They did jack up the knife a little bit. Like, I noticed that it actually does more damage than OG RE2. The downside is you actually have to use it, so yeah. But the OG RE2 knife is pretty stinky, so I support this. Either that or it's just like, whatever reason, normal mode has like some damage multiplier on it or something. Okay, let's go see Sherry. Or where I assume Sherry is, anyway. Is anyone there? Evans, you're alive! I'm Alyssa! Why not it's Alyssa? I'm still here. Where are you both? I'm in a room with many monitors. Sherry. Oh no. You lost her, right? She's fast. More or less. What's wrong with her? She told me her father did something to her, and now she has some kind of repellent for monsters. I'll tell you when we meet again. Now, we have to find her, and don't let her escape again. I will try to find you. Be careful. I hope that's a good story. I think I'll publish a newspaper article if we get out of here. I don't mind fighting Umbrella. We talk later. they'll fucking kill you. This man's head is gone. Lab security manual. How to prevent the T-virus evolution. One of the latest experiments has gone completely wrong. It seems the T-virus can now get mixed with the G-virus under appropriate conditions. Some of our scientists, along with spiders that we kept for tests, have been infected with the TG-virus. The spiders have grown really big and acquired strange white colors. On the other hand, the infected scientists have turned into living dead, but these ones are uncommon. They present an extraordinary regenerative power. Ooh, regenerators. Even the mutilation of their head does not interfere with their regeneration, what makes them apparently immortal beings. Worst of it all, the giant white spiders seem to be connected to these immortal zombies in some way. And the former will try to inoculate the humans with some sort of substance that turns their skin into a crimson color. Once this happens, the infected humans will evolve and acquire greater strength and speed. Oh god. There are two ways of preventing this abominable viral evolution. One, killing the spiders. May not seem the fastest solution, but these spiders are highly resilient to any kind of damage. This may seem the fastest solution, but they're highly resilient to any kind of damage. Finding the alpha infected zombie and covering his body with a special acid. Special acid will not stop their regenerative nature, but they will not evolve into something worse. The acid can be synthesized in medical room at these facilities, in the VAM, but first, a CM7 chemical must be put into the machine. No, we just wasted one of those, I think. Ooh, 10 shotgun shells. Broken shotgun. Broken shotgun, it seems to be broken. I seem to need something to fix it. You jerks. Okay. Here's a repair kit for... What? The fuck? So wait, there's an item box over here. But there's also an item box right here. This item box doesn't work. I could try to use a new storage system in this room. Nice. Nice meme. Okay, well, I'm not going to carry the broken shotgun, and I'm not carrying a separate knife. But I will save. Since we can finally save now. And we finally saved. I hope I get more than 2 saves this time, unlike the last chapter. Oh yeah, they're regenerating, alright. Let's get the fuck out of here. I might need to go down another corridor that Alyssa went down with the spiders in it. That could be important. Main fuse has been removed. Okay, yeah. Just like regular RE2. Door doesn't move. I need to activate. Oh, right, yeah, yeah. You can't go in there till you activate the power system in general. I might need to go up that elevator to get the fuse. Not sure. It's actually really neat. Right, power. But they got the zombies to, like, stay down when I first killed them. But then they got back up as soon as I came back in the room. I'm sure that required a lot of custom coding. Doggies! Nice doggies! Aw, man, we're back to the German Shepherds. Not cool, man. Alright. Oh, cool. That probably fixes the shotgun. Ooh, 10 more shells. Wow. Glad I came in here. Maybe I should go get the shotgun. Oh, nice. Another CM7. Machines are all useless now. Anything over here? The interior has been destroyed by the plant. Yeah. True. Hope this isn't dangerous. Well, we just saved, so... Who cares? Lab card. Nice. What horrible thing is about to happen to me? This mod doesn't just give out stuff like this for free. Unless the third part's really easy or something. That. Okay, no, I don't even have the easy one loaded, so. I did not launch that one by mistake. I only loaded in the normal ones. It saved hard drive space, more or less. Okay, so there's no point in decapping these guys, but I might want to kill that spider. But at the same point, this group of them, it might not matter at all, you know? I was hoping they'd be on the ground again. Oh, fuck. Double fuck, reset the room. If I just run, I'll be okay, I'm pretty sure. Because they're in a pretty nice position. Unless that randomizes, I'm not really, not really sure which way that leans. Okay, yeah, we can just run through there. I'm a little worried about the guys in the elevator, though. They're kind of blocking it. Yeah, right. I forgot. The totally needed change to use this thing instead. Oh, right, I can only stack 10 at a time. Oh, nice! It has, added ammo in. More powerful than its previous version, it fires special shells. Oh, fuck you! God damn it! Here we go again with the special ammo. Alright, I'm taking this with me because I need to pour it into that thing. Synthesize some acid. Wait, maybe I just put it like on some like grenade shells or something. Well, we'll figure that out in a minute. I don't think I can run through those guys. No! I almost fucked that up. Now I can. Please? Oh god. Actually, getting out of there is going to be hell, too, but it doesn't really matter, because even if I take them down, they're just going to get back up. I guess that's another reason to possibly take out the spider. Actually, it didn't really say what would happen if I take the spider out. Will that just prevent them from mutating, or will that actually kill the fuck off with this... camper? Oh, he's fast! Oh! Crimson heads. Leave me alone. The spider's not even here now. I had to know beforehand to kill that spider. What nonsense is that? Oh. That was a switch I had to press. Sure, why not? Hey, three of them. Wow. This is definitely cluttering my inventory up. God damn it. Okay. The memes, man. The memes. Oh, wait, I can save right here. I feel like it's kind of unnecessary to save right now because we've barely done anything, but whatever. That decision could totally screw me over, like, hours down the line, but whatever. It's a risk I've got to take. I don't know exactly how to do this, by the way. Again, I haven't played a B scenario in like a really long time. Like, I want it like here, right? And then I push it this way. Wait, no. I need to be able to get behind it. Oh yeah, we're good. We got enough clearance. Cool. Pushing boxes. The video game. Just to make sure it's in place. So many places to go. But I bet this box resets if I leave the room, so I better not. Oh wait, no, it can't reset. There. There forever. It'd be a neat trick to... a really mean trick to put an item under that. So if you don't check before you push it over there. I have a key card. What? Nonsense. Am I not in the right spot? Or is this just not the key card? It's a key card for lab access. This is the lab, is it not? What? Okay, I thought I couldn't go back down. Must be a different key card. Spiders. I hear spiders. I guess I should probably kill them because that was not pleasant at all. Oh, fuck! Oh, you dick. Oh my god. Jesus. Yeah, and we're in danger. On the plus side, now we have inventory space again. LOL. Okay, hopefully that guy stays dead now. Iron smelting pool. Employees only. Only employees can be thrown into that thing. I really didn't need to take 2,000 hits from that guy. This looks like the alpha infected zombie. It should prevent evolution by creating acid in the medical room or by killing the spiders. Okay, well, we got one spider. Dude, I need this, but holy crap. Oh yeah, turn that on for sure. Okay, that's all that was there. Thank goodness. See, the fact that that's pluralized makes me think I need to go get multiple spiders. Which I don't like the prospect of that at all. but we can come back here if we do get the spraying powder or whatever you want to call it. Just to triple check, now that the power's back on, I can't... Yeah. So, this is a really weird mechanic. I don't know how else to put it. That's just gotta be the wrong key. So we're now in the territory of where I'm like 50-50 on knowing what to do. In general, I have trouble remembering what to do in the lab at the end of RE2. But especially since we're doing like the B scenario stuff, I really don't remember. Plus, it's also modded, so some of it's not even normal. Oh god! Yeah. Well, it didn't kill you. Oh, there we go. Bring it on. What the hell? I killed that spider. How did more of you get, like, red infected? These guys better not be super infected down here. Or I'll tell you what. They're gonna get one stern talking to from me. Okay, good. Oh god. I can't see shit, lol. Please, aw, oh, they're flanking me. Actually, better idea. Now that I knocked that one down, he should be getting up when I leave and come back. So I should be able to kind of get through here quickly, I think. Maybe. Nice. No! Get off me. No! The double bite. Okay, good, I pushed him down. No! All of you fuck off. Although, also, I need to get in there, kind of, and store this stuff. Ah, fuck you guys. Well, this is really bad, but on the bright side, oh, that was, oh my god. Okay. I'm taking one of these with me still. I'll leave that behind. Yeah, I guess that'll be okay. What the hell? Oh, good, we're in danger. Well, okay, I definitely need to reload my save from earlier, but let's explore a little bit. Okay, so we have power, we should be able to go over here. We should be able to make those shutters go up also. Davies. Jones! Alright, Jones was in the lab. Oh god, you're alive! If you hadn't activated power, I would have died here. Glad to see you alive. How much time have you been here? Almost 30 hours. Where's the rest of the team? They're dead, all of them. Davies did it. He was sent by Umbrella to kill us. This is crazy. I found the girl. She's in the lab. We have to find her, and then we'll escape from the city. That's good news. And Davies? Where is him? I don't know. That bastard is our mortal mission to kill him. Or sorry, our moral mission is to kill him. He'll try to kill us if he finds us. That coward. So if we do survive, what will we do? Umbrella doesn't want us alive. We can complete our mission and maybe we won't be murdered. Or we can leave the girl here and escape. No, that wouldn't be right. We'll complete the mission. Anyway, Evans, be careful. I have to go. Alright, bye, I guess. Let's see what we can open. So now we have 0 full heals and 1 small heal. I think I need to use the keycard elsewhere, and that's what it's telling me. Oh, right. I'm thinking of the outbreak way to open that door. Registering fingerprints and whatnot. Well, we can go over here at least. Hey man, we're cold-blooded mercenaries that are somehow also incredibly loyal to Umbrella. What in the hickety heck? I think there's a computer in one of these rooms. Doggies again. Machines are all useless now. Okay. Probably not in this room. Oh god, zombies are in here now. Ah, Jones. You're here. Got the key to access the lower areas. Oh, good. Thank you. The lab, but I don't think it's a good idea to get down. Why? There are many things down there. I've avoided most of them because they're very dangerous. Jones, we have to find the girl. It's our mission. I don't like what I'm doing, but I'd do it. It's a way to advance without fighting them, just for you. I have to tell you something. Evans, you're infected. What? How? All this area is full of gaseous virus, and your mask is damaged. Damn. How will that help me? If you take off your mask, you'll speed up the contamination. But some monsters won't try to attack you. The problem is that you could die quickly. So if I try to fight them, I'll probably die. But if I take off my mask, I won't need to fight. But I could become a zombie very soon. I'm fucked up. Exactly. It's your choice. If you want the key, here, you have it. And remember that Sherry and Alyssa must be infected too. You don't know Alyssa's here. Will you take off the mask? I mean, I feel like this is the bad ending, but yeah, I'll take off the mask. Well, I have no choice. I'll take it off. Good luck, Hunk. I hope we can survive this. And rescue the girl. I'll stay here. I'm exhausted. Lazy Jones. Whoa, look at us! Anyway. Okay, I don't use that computer, but... I'm sorry, Evans. I'm exhausted. Continue alone. Thanks for nothing, jerk. There's more of them now. What? The lunge. There we go. Good. Alright, good. He's down, down. Neither of those guys have anything. God, the camera angles. This hallway was not meant for combat, damn it. Okay, we got him. He's down for the count. Can I hit this guy, please? There we go. Oh, he's not dead. Come on, get him. We're gonna taste the knife. I read Mortal Kombat. Well, I'm sorry that you misread. Fuck! No! That's really bad. I don't really like Mortal Kombat, to be honest. But also, hello, Carlos. Huge plant fills the room. These guys won't attack me, right? Be cool. Okay. Nice. God. Wow. I can't even imagine fighting all these plants down here. This requires the MO disc, right? Yeah. Oh, also, it needs the emergency to happen. Well, Sherry's probably not quite infected so much as, like, she's already infected. Alyssa, are you still here? Nope, she's not here. Contamination has been detected. In the area, doors will be locked until the menace gets solved. Excuse me? Oh, hey G2. Uh-oh. This could be bad for me. I hope I can get in that storage chest over there. If I can't, we're probably going back to our last save. Which isn't the worst thing in the world, because I've taken a lot of damage. Birkin, get your ass over here. Is this guy kidding me right now? There we go. Much rather have him on screen before I shoot my precious 5 bullets of ammo. 5. No, don't do it! Oh, come on, the combo! Well, at least I'm not in danger. I'm not even in caution. Birkin, you weak. Please let me in. Oh, thank God. Okay, so we can get some advanced shotgun ammo. I think that's probably the way to go. Oh, fuck. No, that's bad. That's really bad. Okay. Well, now we're in regular caution. Okay, it seems like the Magnum bullets were doing better against him. I'll try those. Or at least it stunned him more. Oh, he was almost dead. Oh, wait, no, that's not him dying. That's right. Well, now he's dead. Get wrecked. Nice. I will take this key. Birkin? I killed him. What was he doing here? Did he revive again? Excellent question, Hunk. Now that's a lot of damage. That is true. We did indeed do some big damage to that man. Oh, that's cool. Okay, so that doesn't turn into, like, no bullets. Although we still can only fit 5 in there, which is weird. Okay, medical room. Where even is that? That's like upstairs, right? No. Everything upstairs is locked with the key card. So that must just be over here or something. Definitely gonna save. Cause we're gonna need to reload that other save, but this way we can at least explore from here. Okay. I don't like this. Everything's locked to the keycard. No, I don't want to inspect Birkin. There's no other doors in here, right? Yeah, it's not like Outbreak where there's a center door. I can't think of a single room I wasn't able to get into. Right. That makes sense. Well, okay, let me rephrase that. All the doors I couldn't get into, I'm pretty sure they all said that I need to be, like, authorized, or I need the keycard. Or the main power needs to be on was the other one. A huge plant fills the room. Now I gotta go through this stupid hallway again. Oh, nice, this is all infected now. Nothing there. No! Spider! I think I should blast this spider. Hey, get off the ceiling. Oh god, he's gonna drop on me. Shit, I'm wasting ammo, I think. Stop! Don't do it! I don't have any blue herbs. Oh wait, there's some in the main area if I need them. There, he's dead. Jeez. What a menace. Okay. Now these zombies won't turn crazy infected. Dude, I can't even get to the stupid medical room. Okay, yeah, we've been over here. We don't need to go in any of these rooms. But we killed the spider, so these guys shouldn't turn into supers, even though that didn't really work last time, but whatever. So that's that hallway. I guess I could try the blue door, but I'm like 100% sure, like, the one door you need the main power to be on. The other door, you need a key card, it said, that I don't have. What the hell was that thing? What is that? Oh, I'm wrong. Oh well. I'm pleasantly wrong. Oh yeah, I guess this is the medical room, isn't it? Oops. Can I get this, please? Yeah, alright, full heal. Oh, and there's more. Awesome. I feel like there's going to be more ammo than there is, like, places I can use it. Oh, I don't have the compound with me. Damn it. Yeah, okay, I can make synthesis with this. Or I can synthesize some, like, whatever with this. Alright, we can use that for some things. Right. It's a side pack. Oh, nice! More inventory space. Thanks, zombie. And some chemicals. All right. And more. Oh, this guy's the best. Zombie. You're a true hero, bud. I guess we'll synthesize some acid. Nice. Oh, it's the logo for the BC ammo. Or BC gunpowder in Resident Evil 3. Now the question is, where does this stupid red key card go to? And is that guy gonna fuck me up? What in the hell are those things? These monsters. I've never seen this before. Oh, this is just opened? What? Since when? Alright, that guy's gonna bite me. Unless I do this. Dude, hell yeah. These zombies are the best. They have all the items. Control box used for super low temperature control. I could set a superconductor fuse here if I had a fuse case. Right, that's how we turn the power back on all the way. So, we'll need to come back here. That's not a problem. Good call on including like a ton of ammo to pick up, because holy crap, this mechanic could get really annoying. Or actually the side pack too. It's good design all around. You know what's weird? I am not pressing the open door button at that door specifically. It just like loads as soon as I walk up to it. Okay, so now I gotta ask myself, is the red key card for the area down there, or is it for the one over here? And I feel like I should check this one out first. Not just because it's red, but that door did it too. So weird. But because we've already cleared this area out, whereas the other place has zombies. Although they might have despawned at this point, or even respawned. So I don't need to torch that zombie, but I might want to try that in the other area. Or if I see a new area that we go to, I might toss down some acid. Hello, plants. I like that they literally have no collision. Whatever. I'm not proud. I'll take my bad ending than over having to fight all of these freaking plants. At least I assume that's what's gonna happen. I don't even know if that's gonna happen. I might just not die anyway. Because plot armor or whatever. Yeah, we definitely have plenty. Let me... Yeah, we'll use it... Wait, how much do I have overall? Do I have any more acid? Or compound? I do have more compound. Cool. Very cool. So I think I'll just use these two on these things. And then we have another full clip of... Hey, what's up, D314? Actually, we have another full clip and then some. What the hell? Can I not combine these? I had a stack of 8 earlier. Okay. There we go. What the items on the shelves are. Where? Oh, in the art. Yeah, so there's... What did I draw on there? There's some, like, coloring books, puzzles like Sudoku and crosswords. There's crayons, there's some gift wrap. I forget what else I put on there. This seems like an excessive number of items, but I think it'll be good. Oh yeah, and glue. Agent Davies, request evacuation for Raccoon City's underground laboratory. You have the security codes, so all sent agents won't have anything to worry about. I'm located at the laboratory of the east area of the facilities. So he's here. I need those codes to exit this place. Yeah, the box is the crayons. Things are freaking me out. They're gonna activate at some point. Oh no, they're not activating because I took my helmet off, probably. Cool. The triangles? Oh, those are party hats. God, the inventory spam on this part of the game. It's insane. Yeah, all the doors are just automatically opening when I walk up to them now. Which, in all fairness, that's how it would work with the keycard, I guess. Or like if you had like a fob or something. What do we got here? Goodness gracious. Okay, well that's everything. Thankfully, because I don't have any more space anyway. I'm gonna probably eat that herb as soon as I get into the next room. Unlock the gate to the train with this. Oh yeah, okay. So I don't have the codes. I can't use it till I find. Yeah. I bet Davies is in this room or something. Like the lab room over here. Should I put this away? I don't even know. There's like so much crap in my inventory right now. You know, I mean the box is right here. I might as well. I'm also just realizing those are probably just, they probably just have Flicker AI, so probably nothing crazy. Alright. Actually, you know what? No. We're gonna transform this. And then, we're gonna keep a full stack with us. Oh, 8 is the max. What a weird number. Okay, put this away, put this away. I'm gonna keep the herb with me, though. Because I don't know what I'm walking into here. Can't open it. I need to activate the main power source. You son of a gun. Okay, we probably need to go down to that other area then. Alright, so this is probably the dumbest save I've done yet. But you know what? I'm feeling risky. Let's see how much time there is between this and my last save. It's like a little over 10 minutes. Okay. I'm paranoid though. I mean, I really shouldn't be. Oh, fuck. I guess I could blast this guy. I'm not gonna get past him without taking a bite, I'm pretty sure. Bam! Freeze, zombie. Oh my god, I hit the guy back here, too. That's what you get. Mess with me. Alright, let's get out of here, because they're gonna regenerate. Okay, the powered up magnum might actually be insanely powerful. Oh wait, this is not the door I need to go into. And maybe I should actually be using the shotgun. But yeah, as far as stuff left, I mean, we really just have to activate the main power, which we need to go get the power source, then go into the cold room to synthesize it and bring it back out here to the center. Oh, come on with this. Hey, we got two. I will take it. Get out of my way, please, gentlemen. Oh, don't run, don't run, don't run, don't run. Yes, okay. I think I need that key card in the lab. Now that I think about it. Oh well. Oh, you! Eh. I was too slow to freaking decide. Okay, we're using this. Don't do it! Oh my god. That hallway is gonna be hell. Forever. Although this should be... I hope this is the last time we need to go through here. I don't think there's any other reason to come back to this area. But that's actually the main reason I stayed. I knew this was going to be like a really annoying area. And even though we didn't do that much, there was a lot of running back and forth. And I don't want to have to repeat that. Especially since it seems like we don't have too much else to do in the lab. And there's no other areas in Resident Evil 2. So unless they toss us in some like crazy areas. Oh, that's a doggy. Nice doggy. Let's be cool. Sorry, dog. Had to be this way. Cool, so we got this thing. Let's go ahead and put some fuel in that bad boy. And... you know, I have expected Birkin to pop out or something. Like the central control system, all the control switches are locked. Oh, I might need to come back here for that. Right. Damn it. Get out of here. Yeah, screw this. I love the way they fucking do that. Oh shit, he's running. We got a runner. Oh, he's also aggroed. Okay, go, 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 go. There's one more around the corner, I know. Don't get me. Yes. The elevator secondary power is off again. What? 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 What kind of gotcha bullshit is this? Oh no! Push them both. No! You didn't push good enough. Of course, I had to go down here and turn the power back on again. I should have known. And we wasted those shells, because those zombies I headshotted, they're coming back. Haha, lol. Got them. Which, I'm pretty sure that's broken, by the way, because I killed the spider down here. I don't know. I guess this area is not infected with super zombies, so... maybe all that's it, that maybe that's all it was supposed to do. In those other two rooms, there's nothing you can do about the fact that there's just going to be... some crimson fuckers in there. Please fall. Thank god. Are you dead, dead? I can't really tell from this angle, but it looks like yes. I'm gonna save. I don't know what the end boss is. I'm sure I'm gonna have like more than enough ammo to blow the end boss away, but I'm mildly worried about that, especially because I want to shoot more of those red guys when I'm, or aggroed guys, whatever the fuck they're called. Super, super duper regenerators. Oh, he is dead. Okay. The alpha's gone, by the way. Weird. Who turned them off? I thought Davey's gonna be in here to like, haha, suck on this, hunk. But no, it just turned off. I hope turning the main power on doesn't like turn that off. If I were hunk, I'd probably toss those zombies in the smelting pool, just saying. Yes, this is a completely different storyline. It takes place during the events of Resident Evil 2, basically what Hunk was doing during that time. Except it is also an alternate storytelling because Leon and Claire both died. But yeah, we basically team up with Alyssa from Resident Evil Outbreak to escape the city. Yep, they died in the RPD basically in this storyline. Oh, this guy. Yeah, you know what? Heck you. Wait, the other ones are gone. So the Crimson Heads actually stayed dead? Is that what I'm seeing here? Then that means two of them that I shot earlier will also be dead down here. I don't know why I'm wasting so much ammo and health. Wait, I went back outside. Damn it. No, they're not dead at all. God damn it. They've respawned. I forgot to press the button. Whoopsie doodle. So, I only have one full heal now. I used my single green herb. Hey guys. Shit, that's good enough for me. Oh, they actually killed them somehow. So I guess when they respawn, they do that instead. I hope I don't need to go over there again, but I might. There's gonna be more shit over here though. But I'm just gonna hope it's not red zombies, because I killed a spider over here, goddammit. It should... Oh, right, now it's just these guys. Nice. I wonder if Jones is dead. Let's go look. Because, like, this whole hallway is fucked now. Yeah. Oh. Right. I was like, yeah, do it. Duh. It's totally gonna make me go down to the lab, then come back up into that side room up here, I'm pretty sure. I will take the main fuse, thank you very much. Yeah, I think the difficulty is a good balance in this mod. He said right before he got one-shotted. No. I definitely made the first chapter harder for myself because I was trying to be like overly like cautious with ammo because I didn't know where the first chapter ended. But yeah, like chapter 2, we only died once legitimately. I died when I killed Davies, but I like kind of knew there was like a 50-50 chance I was going to just instantly die when I did that. Literally just like, do you want to self-destruct yourself? Yes or no? And I was like, yeah, hell yeah, give me that. But, dope-ass mod, though. I like it a lot. Davies! Where are you running? There's nothing over there. Oh, he went in the vent, didn't he? What the hell? You're alive! You have the security codes of the lab, right? What are you talking about? You're wrong! You're going to die here very soon. Don't make it harder. I had to avenge all our partners. Stop, Hunk. Umbrella will hunt you if you do it. Do I have any other option? Put that gun down. Put it down, son of a bitch. I can't. Ooh. Game over. Oh, we didn't get the codes. I wonder if there's a way you can get the codes. Oh, they're just on him. Why did we even hesitate? Just shoot him outright. Why did I put my gun down? Oh, that's his gun. Can I take it? I don't think I can. Whatever, I already have a shotgun. I don't need a second one. Thanks, Davies. See you never. I'm curious about this, though. Like, what if it's a super shotgun or something? I guess we have the super shotgun, so... Nuts to that gun. Maybe that's there in case you don't have a shotgun on you, just to explain where the fuck that shotgun came from. That's the only thing I can think of. Oh, this is probably gonna be flooded with enemies. Doggies! Sorry, doggy. Okay, we just need to get out of here. No need to stick around and, do this. Give me your loot. I don't have anything. Now, to be fair, there was one time where a dog had loot in this game, so I'm not like... Why doesn't the dog have loot on him? Okay, that spider worked. It must be whatever room it's in. And I don't think there was a spider in two of those rooms. Oh, wait, okay. Well, the one room... As Alyssa, there was a spider. But I had no idea what the spiders did at that point. Which is vaguely interesting, but also kind of annoying, considering you can't really go back unless I restart the entire chapter. Okay. Should I save yet? I bet I'll have another chance. So yeah, I'll wait, but I am gonna swap some stuff in the old inventory crate here. I think I have like another acid somewhere in here. Oh, I do. But I've only got 5 shotgun shells, so I assume those won't turn into like the same number of shotgun shells. We've just got 1 save left. Alright, yeah. Well, so, the codes will open the end door, so that'll probably trigger some crazy cutscene. I'm gonna go in the lab first. Or, I don't know what you call this room, but I'm gonna go in this room first. Nope. Oh, it's totally locked. Totally. The fuck? Store blocked by some kind of metal detection system. I need to leave all my weapons in the item box if I want to cross this door. we're CVX now, I guess. Okay. That's not terrifying at all. Well, I mean, I can't put my knife away, so I guess I'll at least have one weapon. I don't know if it considers ammo or herbs a weapon, but I'm gonna hope no. Let's trick the system and put our knife away. Thing is gonna murder the shit out of me in here. Nothing, hey? Nice. I will take that. Even though I don't really need it at this point. In fact, this acid's really just burning my inventory, or burning a slot in my inventory. Oh, dude, this mod's so nice. I don't know if it's just because it was, like, me playing a mod for the first time, but the first chapter seemed way harder than chapter 2 or 3 here. Vaccine synthesis machine. There's a vaccine inside. The vaccine is supposed to eliminate any kind of virus. I could heal myself or heal Sherry or Alyssa. She must be infected, too. I can't continue without this. I'm almost dead. Oh, shit. I'm sorry for doing this, but I'll find a way to keep them alive and get them out of here. You've used the vaccine. Oh, shit. Who is that? Who's that making the fucking RE4 regenerator music noise? Show yourself. I can't fucking see. Oh! Invisible enemies. Oh, God. Get me off. No. I am playing that. Yeah. Fuck this. I'm out. Oh, you fucker. Get off me. What is that? It's not a normal zombie. Okay. Oh, yeah, I'm healed. That's bad. That's real bad. They know. They fucking know! Okay, I shouldn't have run, because they're lickers, so I can just walk. Oh, God. Give me a goddamn heart attack. Alright. Let's operate this shit. Hey, what's up, Sherry and Alyssa? How'd you get in here? Oh, yeah. Heavens, you're alive! Oh, Sherry. Where were you? Stay with me. Till we get out of here, please. Okay, where's your mask? I thought you were younger. You're fit. I took it off to reach you sooner. That doesn't make any sense out of context. The monster was tough, but I killed it. You did it? And Alyssa? I don't know where she is. She probably found another way to reach the train platform. I'll open the gate to the train platform. And we'll get out of this damn city. Sounds fine, but I'm feeling bad. I think it's because of what my father did to me. I'm getting worse. I think there should be a vaccine or something. About that, Sherry. In my father's lab. I went there before, but there was nothing. Hunk, you son of a bitch. Oh. It's time to go. The gate to the train platform has been unlocked. The gate to us getting eaten alive by lickers has also been unlocked. Oh, they're not in here. Nice. Sherry killed all those lickers on her own. Good job, Sherry. Oh, we're gonna have to deal with those plants, too. That's okay. There's just a short little jaunt there. Okay. Save time. Big save. Take literally everything with us, because why wouldn't we? Whoa, what are these? Oh, yeah, never mind. These are my guns. Oh, I'm an idiot sometimes. Okay, put this stuff away. Dude, this is rocking. I hope it's not copyrighted. I haven't used this lab key card yet, so I'm gonna keep it with me just in case. Let's do this. 20 minutes between that and the last save. Much better. Alright. What is this gonna do? Oh, it gives you a full 8! God damn! Okay. Take the acid with us. You know, I probably should leave space. Actually, you know what? Just in case, I'm gonna put that away. Like, if there's, like, a battery or some two-slot item thing. Maybe Sherry killed these guys, too. She did. Good job, Sherry. I'm going to search Jones, one of my team members. Stay here. God damn it. Alright, come back soon. Alright, Jones. Let's get you home so you can start your truck rental and storage business. I mean, I'm basically ammo man right now. I might as well just blast everything in my fucking path. Like this guy. BAM! Oh, I halved him. His lock is released. Oh, yeah. Or maybe even this guy, too. Oh my god, the carnage. I went backwards, that's not good. Okay. Alright, let's not waste all the ammo. Oh, wrong door. Fuck. Don't mind me, doggies. Oh, they're minding me. Oh, I can't go through that suddenly. That's stupid. That's really dumb. Jones. Let's get the hell out of here, Jones. He's like, alright. I'm game. Nice, it teleported us down here. So she's the girl. Yes. Glad to see her alive, right? He's gonna shoot her, isn't he? Of course. I'll advance and check the next room. What happened to I'm exhausted? Alright, be careful. He looks nice. How much time do we have to exit this place? Oh, I gotta go back for the other thing, don't I? We have enough time. I don't know if we should search Alyssa in this moment. Oh, but we will try it, right? Of course. Let's go. I don't know if she's just gonna be down here or what. Sherry? You were right behind me and then you fucked it all up. Wait a moment, Sherry. It could be dangerous. Probably is. Are we gonna get a Nemi fight or a Birkin fight? Jones, where are you? Jones is gonna mutate. He's been infected. Oh, or we're just gonna fight G3. Oh no, Nemesis! Three Nemesis! Oh my god! Four Nemesises! Don't stop it! Don't do it! Okay. Please tell me. Oh, god. I don't think it's working. I don't have the ammo for this crap. Help. Okay, that's at least hitting most of them. God damn it, fall. You bastards. Oh, I gotta run out of ammo before I kill these guys. Yeah, that one's not even dead yet. What the fuck? Alyssa, help me! Show up magically and save the day. Okay, none of them are dead, and we have three magnum bullets left. Good. I got one! I got two of them! We're fucked. Maybe they had more ammo on them. I really hope I don't need any more bullets in this chapter. I should probably heal? I'm not sure. Wait, maybe this guy had a super gun on him. Whoa, buddy! And a vaccine. Okay, I will heal with this one. What do I use this on? Parts for a gun, okay. Yo! Jones, how did you lose like this? I guess he didn't have a gun to turn them into. I'm curious about something before I kill these guys off. No, they didn't drop anything. Take that. What? We never left the RPD. What the? Another nightmare? Oh my goodness. Don't do this to me. I mean, I should definitely save, right? Can I talk to you? Searching in the hall, in the middle of the star. First the right, then the left. Up and then back. Will you start the sequence? Right, left, up, back. Star in the middle of the hall. Okay. What? Right? I can't inspect anything. Left. Up. And then back. Help. Searching in the hall, the middle of the star. First the right, then the left, up and then the back. Right. Left. Up. And back. Okay. Middle. Right. Left. Up. Back. I don't understand this at all. What do you want from me, game? I can go in here? What the hell? And there's invisible enemies here. I think I just died. No, he didn't die. He's not dead. Or maybe he is. Maybe his blood's invisible too. Nope, I ran into him. He's still alive. Now he's dead. This is chapter 3. We finished chapter 2 last night. Oh, wait. Oh, okay. Now I get it. Okay, so we start in the middle, so this one. Then we go right. Correct, yes, the last chapter. Then up, then back. So I guess coming back is like, come back to that one, but I'm guessing to the right is east, which should be this way. Or it's out in the courtyard. I guess I'll check the courtyard first. We're in some weird nightmare sequence to get you up to speed on what's going on. Ah, here we go. Activate it. Oh, I can only activate it from the front. Okay. You invisible son of a gun. No drops from him. Okay. So the right, then to the left. Super glad I checked on this. Oh, you respawned. That didn't sound very good. What the hell? Like, I got a sound the last time I did one of them, but not that time. Oh, the ladder's not up. Well, hopefully I can go this way. What's up with my dropping frames or anything, am I? No. Zero drop frames. Good. We got him. Actually, we didn't got him. He's still alive. Now we got him. Oh. Well, what the hell does that mean? Okay, it didn't happen in the last chapter, we just killed him. Okay, maybe this is up? I think we already screwed it up, but I'll check anyway. I should check if I can go in other rooms. I probably can. I think the sound that we got was a good confirmation that we got the right one the first time. So maybe that last one I did is actually the quote-unquote back one. Although this seems like it would be the back, right? Dude, my Twitch will not let me fucking see my stream. Like, yeah, timeout. LOL. Well, those have to be the four. There's no other way. First the right, then the left. Up, and then back. Yeah, I don't... It doesn't really make sense to me, but... Whatever. I mean, I guess technically I did kill him yesterday also, because I did the thing where it's like, will you kill Davies? He's got a bomb strapped to him and it will definitely kill you. I seem frustrated. No, I'm good. What a weird thing to say. I guess I'm a little lost in what this puzzle wants me to do, if anything, but no, I'm still enjoying this mod. I'm gonna try this one. Okay, that didn't make a noise, so I'm gonna reset it. I think I can brute force this, I don't know. And maybe... Well, let's read this again. Searching the hall. In the middle of the star. First the right, then the left. Up, and then the back. So yeah, I don't know how to interpret that other than what I already did, but... Yeah, like, up would make me think, like, there's one, like, here or something, or, like, upstairs. But yeah, right is this way, left... I could see left meaning this way, but I don't know. Wait, maybe I, like, was onto something earlier, because I didn't hear something there, but then the zombie moan happened at the same time, so I don't know. Well, let's see what happens. If this one makes a noise, then I think we're on the right track. Otherwise, I don't know. Nah, nothing. Damn it. Oh, we can go in here. Oh! Some of these might be decoys. There's zombies in here. On the flippin' ground. Maybe it's more than just, four of them. Oh, wait, hold on a second. Excuse me. Yarr. Maybe it's actually five movements. So if I plot these out as, like, in a star formation... Well, hold on, that's not right, because then... Oh my god, I didn't even activate this. That's why everything was messed up. Okay. suppose I don't really need this hoodie. It's like 70 degrees out right now, which is really awesome. And it probably dropped a bit since the sun went down, but... Okay. So right, left, and then... I don't know. I think to some degree this part does kind of suck all the energy out of the room. Like, we just had our big boss fight, and now we're in weird cerebral section. But I... Oh, you bastard. I don't think that really takes anything away from this mod. It's pretty great in general, so... Damn it, that wasn't the one. Okay, I can't go in here. That's good. To tell where that guy is. I need to be a little more careful when I walk through that room. So, I haven't tried this office as, like, the second one, and I meant to do that. I totally, forgot to check that one first. Because I know, so technically I know we did that, but it's, yeah. What do you call it? I can go in here too? Oh no! The locations, they keep multiplying. The question is there actually a statue in here? There probably is somewhere. I'll check the hallway. And there's our enemy too! Haha! Shoot. Okay, let me see if I can go through any of these doors. I should figure out where all the locations are, then maybe the puzzle will actually make sense. Instead of trying to brute force this, as I've been doing. You fuck. Get out of here. He didn't die. Or did he die? Usually they make a weird hissing sound when they die. Okay. My hope is that there's no more doors that are opened. Like, I'm hoping this is the extent to which the puzzle is laid out. Is there another one in here? Okay. Oh god, this hallway is valid, though. Hey, it has the hole. The Mr. X hole. Oh, I didn't even see that guy there. Okay, so there's one there. These doors aren't working. Good. That is good. I can't see exactly where this guy is. Oh, he's way over there. Can I just knife him around the statue? Aw, oh, yeah, get wrecked. Ah, oh, he's dead. Okay, so... So, center, then right... God, okay. You know what? There's one more door I need to try, and I have a feeling it's going to open. This hallway here. Aha! Okay. And I'm hoping neither of these doors do anything. That one doesn't. Got really close to getting bit there. Oh god, this does do something. Well then how the heck is this the center? This is like nowhere near the center of the area that is in play here. Oh, wow. That's scary. Oh my god, this is also in play. Wait, and why have the other door completely unusable? That's just freaking weird. The thing I appreciate the most out of this invisible enemy mode is the fact that I can still like knife. Or I still auto-aim at the invisible enemies. Okay, the stairs do not work. And then just because this mod hates us, this freaking door doesn't work, so we can't loop around. Okay, so this is the entirety of the area here. And we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 statues. That is way more than there are it's way more than there are number of points on a star, so I have no freaking clue how the star plays into any of this. Oh, come on, but that's... None of this damage actually matters, because, like, I did save as soon as I got in here. So worst case, we just reload and... I mean, none of these rooms are cleared anyway, because as soon as you kill any of these guys, they respawn. Yeah, so I'm not gonna brute force my way through this. Let's think about the puzzle again. So we know that the first one is the one over there, which is good. Searching in the hall, in the middle of the star. Okay. First the right, then the left, up, and then back. Don't reset. So here's our star. So first we go to the right. So if we're making a stroke and we're going to the right, this doesn't make any goddamn sense. I'm gonna try one more thing. But yeah, first to the right. And yeah, that's not even how you would, like, draw a star anyway. You wouldn't go right and then just go left immediately. But this also doesn't really form the shape of a star any way I look at it. If we're going to the left, then we would kind of go, like, down into the left. And then up would be, like... Alright, I'm gonna try one really stupid thing, and if that works, then we're good. If it doesn't work, I might just look this up. Yeah. Oh, right, the guy. Hey, we're finally in caution. I've taken like 20 bites so far. That's not it. Okay. One more thing, then I look it up. But if this works, I'm really actually at a loss, so this is more of a shot in the dark. Hmm. I'm also working under the assumption that that sound means I got the right one. That could just be that one always makes that noise, for all I know. Okay. We could be onto something. You gotta be kidding me. Jerk. Jerk alarm's going off. You know what? Screw it. I don't like this puzzle. I'm looking up the solution. I don't care. Until then, enjoy this music. Oh, please tell me I'm, like, not really far away from the end or something crazy like that. Show me the RPD. Okay, cool. Okay, good. There's not very much time in the video left. This guy's save stating. How do you even do that? Ah, he did the same thing I did. Where he, like, used all of his other gun's ammo, then got the Gatling turret out. Oh, this is the next one. I'm sorry, I broke there for a second. That makes no goddamn sense. Wait. Oh, he said no. Okay, so it's not that one. Yeah. Okay, wait, he did this one. Then... Oh my god. He's walking back and forth between them. Probably show you guys, but where's the fun in that? Right? Oh, there's an official walkthrough that the creator posted. I guess I could use that too. I mean, really, the ideal thing would be to just find a text thing. What in the hell? No. His thing just cut off. What? It says all three episodes. And yeah, it just doesn't. At a certain point, it just doesn't. Alright, let's go to the creator. What crazy puzzle have you set forth, Resident Evil Nemesis 30? Episode 1 official walkthrough. How about episode 3 official walkthrough? Nope, nobody's beaten this, guys. We'll be the first if I figure this out. Yeah, right. Seriously, what the fuck? Okay, and then stuff about during the storm, which, awesome. Should subscribe to this guy, actually. Easter eggs? Alright. There are 9 videos labeled walkthrough. Mortal Knight demo walkthrough. There's 4 of them are walkthroughs of the demo. They're also not really like walkthroughs in the way that they're guides, but Mortal Knight Elza Walker edition. What? That's cool. This is a cool mod. It just keeps getting cooler. But also, what the fuck? Okay. I found somebody else. Let's see them play this. Oh shit, I spoiled myself. Okay. What the hell? This guy's cheating. He can see the invisible guys. Either that or he's got like some different play or something. Okay, so I think my next move is to use this East Wing. Oh, you know what? I think he's playing an older version. Now that I look at this. Which I hope the solution's the same. Okay, yeah, so I do all the things in the East Wing. Then we go over to the West Wing, maybe? Yes. And then we do the first one there. And then you just kind of do as you go along. Okay. It seems... And you head back. And then just do the last two up... Oh, no, no. Yeah. Go up into the office. Wait. Which order first? Sorry, I know this isn't the most fun thing to watch. But I'm legitimately... I don't know what this thing's asking me to do. Okay, then you start from the top and go downward in... If anybody in chat, like, has made sense of this, like, pattern here, by all means, feel free to speak up, but I'm it almost makes sense, like, if it was, like, everything in a row. I don't know if it's just worded poorly or what. Right? It's weird. Okay, and then you just go outside and do the last one, and then you're good. Oh, then you actually leave. Okay, I probably would have needed to know that. Unless he says something and I just skipped over. Okay, gotcha. I really shouldn't continue with injuries, but I'm gonna do it. Because, spoilers, I fast-forwarded a bit and there's, maybe some things that require a little more health. Don't do it. Yay! Oh, mama! Yeah, we're still not in orange caution. Yeah, so here's the order. You start here, in this section, you go in, like, this hallway, then in the police office, then in the, like, interrogation room hallway. Then you go along the west hallway path and just grab all of them along the path till you get to the dead end. Then you come back, go into the evidence room, and go back down through Marvin's office, or whatever that room is. Oh, I almost forgot. And ending outside. If anyone knows how the fuck that clue matches up against that sequence of things, please let me know. I don't get it. Just straight up. Where is this guy? Oh, he's right here. Please fall. I was watching a streamer earlier today that, this is a complete non sequitur, and I'm not outing who they are, because they're actually a pretty cool streamer, but they're definitely not, like, a horror fan in general. And they said that Resident Evil 4 was one of the worst games they've ever played. Like, goddamn. It's intense. This person plays a lot of retro games, though, too, so it's... I guess it's not terribly surprising, because, like, I mean, playing retro games doesn't mean you're gonna like old-school survival horror. No! Okay, we're still not in orange. But... I thought that was a weird take. I mean, don't get me wrong, like... I like 4 as a game a lot, but it's like nowhere near the top of my like favorite Resident Evil list, personally. But I mean, to be fair, this like I have probably nice things to say about most of the Resident Evil games, and the ones that I don't. Oh god, no. The ones that I have nothing but mean things to say, I can at least stomach playing them if I like wanted to. Like, I think Umbrella Corps is probably, like, hands down the worst... Oh, he's not dead, okay. The worst RE game, but I would actually rather play that than Gaiden. Like, I think Gaiden... If you consider everything... Oh, god. Like, all pieces to Gaiden. Like, the fact that it was on Game Boy Color, and... It's from the year 2001. It's actually kind of impressive in some light. And it's not the most unfun thing to play ever, but it's bad. Oh snap, we're getting raided. They heard me saying positive things about Gaiden. Hey everybody, welcome in. Thank you for the raid, Starlight. How did Doom go after I left? No, it didn't make the noise. Oh, I missed one, didn't I? Poopy. Your wrist is numb. Damn. Well, I just fucked up a puzzle. How about that? I'm gonna keep going anyway in the assumption that I did this right and it's just not making noise for some reason. I'm gonna say he's pretty much doomed. Take sunglasses off. The Who starts playing. Redeem yourself on deathmatch, which you always say. Said that about RE5. Yeah, that's not the solution. God damn it. We need to go back. Or are we good? Did I need those last two? Oh, there's shit out here. What in the Sam hell? What in tarnation? Okay. By the way, I'm at the most confusing puzzle in the world. And I'm cheating. And even my cheating didn't do the trick for me. Alright, let's go back here. So the last one that worked was the left hallway. So after he did this one, okay, let me make sure. So you did this one. Good. Why did I pause somewhere where there's no music? Hold on. Let me go somewhere so you guys can at least hear stuff. So we're in some weird dream sequence right now. Also, if anyone doesn't know what I'm doing, this is a Resident Evil 2 mod. What the hell? How'd this turn off again? Wait, did it reset all of them when I did this? I'm curious now. Yeah, it might have done it as soon as I picked a bad statue. Oh, these are still lit up. Okay, wait, maybe we can fix our mistake then. I'm just gonna, yeah, if I didn't even know I could do this, but yeah, if this is allowed, I'm just gonna go and try to, like, there's only one other statue it could be now, so we have our solution by brute force. Anyway, this is a classic Resident Evil 2 mod, where you play as Hunk during the events of Resident Evil 2, although it is sort of an alternate history to that, because, stuff that doesn't happen in canon happens in this, so. Well, that's confusing. For example, both Leon and Claire die. Okay, let's take this back. So, I did this hallway. Got that one. And then go back. Wait, was that one already pressed in or not? It was, okay. So, in here. Yeah, so basically we got to the train platform in the laboratory, and then after killing four nemesises, or I guess four prototype nemesis, our character blacked out and is now back in the RPD for some reason. Where they've put in the most annoying fucking puzzle. That, apparently, the solution I'm looking at is not the solution. Because, yeah, it's not working. Well, actually, let me make sure, because I think possibly what's happening here is that I'm just like, Nemesai. Nemesai. Okay, so yeah, this person did exactly what I did. It just didn't work for me. So either there's another statue somewhere I missed, or nothing. I don't know. I don't know what the other solution is here. So he did the one out there, and he went out to the Oh, is this not right or something? Oh, wait, yeah, no, he's seeing the same thing. Okay. If anyone in chat knows the solution to this. That was a meme, by the way. No, none of y'all have played this. No help, yeah. Well, I'm already cheating, so. Oh, I should show you what the puzzle says. Because it's confusing as fuck. Also, I don't know what is going on with this person's capture, but like everything's like broken up into cubes. It's kind of like the bug that we saw when I was playing Clock Tower 3, where things were a little jagged on certain surfaces. That's just like his entire screen all the damn time. It's also an older version, so I don't really know what's going on. Thank you for your contribution to the trash can. Sorry this just came to a dead stop when everyone got here. I legitimately have no idea what this part wants me to do. So he reset everything, and then he went. Okay, yeah, that's the second one I did. And that's the third one I did per his video. Then go in here, do that one. Okay. Okay. Wait, hold on. Okay, never mind. I saw a weird prompt. I thought it was something else. This guy's taking bites like crazy. I don't know what's going on. Oh, crap. Could I go into like the development room or something? I never tried that door, did I? Oh, crap. Well, that's not what he's doing. So I don't. Maybe not. Wait. Go in here. And then. Oh! Maybe I've screwed myself over because I've already done the wrong order. Yeah, okay, I was just following the wrong order. Okay, yeah, that's what happened. Alright, but what the fuck happens when I do the last one? Then I can go in there. Okay. That makes no sense whatsoever, but that's fine. Okay, let's reset this bad boy. And, I guess let's go again. Whee! Reset. Oh, yeah, sorry. Here's the puzzle. I know I scrolled past it. Searching in the middle of the star. Sorry, searching in the hall. In the middle of the star. First to the right, then to the left. Up, and then the back. There are 9 different statues we have to press. What the hell? Or wait, is it 10? Because there's the one extra in the courtyard I didn't know about. But yeah, so that's the clue, and then here's the order they want you to do it. So that's the first one. I could almost see it if you were like going in a line on the map, but that's not even like what this is. Cause like, look at the map, right? I can't point to it, but yeah, the one we just got is like that would be the closest one if you start going right from the center. So that makes sense. But then the next one to the right from there, if you're going to the right, is the one in the evidence hallway. Not this one, which this one is the correct one. So what the fuck? We also have respawning invisible enemies. Fun. They don't do a ton of damage though, so I'll, you know, it's not the worst thing in the world. Plus, they're really easy to dodge. I was kind of expecting to get bitten right as I said that, but thankfully it didn't happen. No! Gets bit by next zombie instead. All right. Mr. Jerkface. Well, the combat part of this chapter has been pretty easy. Although it actually would have been like way, way, way harder if I took my or if I kept my helmet on. But oh well, whatever. Bad ending. Sherry dies. I was expecting that we would die in this bad ending, but no. It's like, oh, I need the vaccine. I guess I'll take it. LOL. Get wrecked, Sherry. It's not a canon story anyway, so... She doesn't need to grow up to be an RE6. By the way, it's weird, but I'm actually kind of excited to come back to RE6. I know that literally everyone in the chat is probably like, fuck that. Oh, this is a band t-shirt. Although it is white, yes. That's correct. You stay down. See? It's got bees on it. Alright, invisible window zombies, don't you grab me. But yeah, again, for anybody that hasn't been around, I'm playing through the mainline Resident Evil series. 1 through 7 plus some more. And that includes the remakes as well as the originals of 1, 2, and 3. Although when I play 6, I'm not gonna play the whole game because it's like 60,000 hours long, and also I hate 3 of the 5 campaigns in there. So we're just gonna be doing, Jake and Sherry's campaign. Which, I feel like everybody likes Leon's the most, which is fine. But Leon's is actually one of my like least favorite, personally. It starts out really cool, because it starts out like it's an actual proper like horror game, and the game lulls you into this thing of like, oh, this is gonna be horror again, okay, that's cool. And then it just becomes like action schlock, just like every other campaign, which Jake's is no different, but if you play as Jake, you get to like have weird hand-to-hand combat, and then Sherry has a special weapon too, so like, it's just, it's fun. It's way more fun with them, in my opinion. And you have, like, you have some of the most linear gameplay, but also you have like the least amount of like cutscenes that you're locked into. That's my biggest problem with Leon's campaign, is like there's so many cutscenes that are like soft cutscenes where you're just like walking around slowly and dialogue's happening and stuff, you basically stuff you can't skip. I hope I didn't absentmindedly do one of them wrong, but I think I've heard clicks on all of them, so we should be good. Anyway, that's my thoughts on 6. I know everybody loves to dogpile and just hate on 6. It's definitely not up there at all on my list of favorite RE games, but I'd go so far as to at least say I like it. Hey, that's a good sound. RE6 is your favorite, yeah, right, Gaius? Mondiou. I love watching people play 6, especially when they actually like it. Like, which is my opposite for like every other Resident Evil. Somehow I love people that are completely like unfamiliar with survival horror play these games. Though they usually get really mad, which is not the enjoyment for me. It's more the like just watching people fumble with like the weird jank in all these games. And that's why I like watching like people play mods too, because mods are all over the place in terms of like difficulty and like what it throws at you. It's super weird that the statues unlight themselves if you get the order wrong, but only the ones that were wrong. So like it looks like you can save it. That's why I got confused there. Apologies for like the half hour detour in this segment that's only supposed to take like, well, okay. I mean, this isn't supposed to be quick, but whatever. I am super excited to, so I guess Alone in the Dark confuses the shit out of me, because I get how historic it is, and like especially the first one, you know, being the grandfather of survival horror, like I totally get that, but that game to me has just aged horribly. Like obviously I didn't play it when it was relevant, because I played it like last year, I think was the first time I played any of those other than the remake. Oh, it's Silent Hill music, and it's Birkin with a pipe. Yeah, I was actually gonna make a comment about that, like, all this stuff feels very, like, cerebral, like in a Silent Hill game. Like this dream sequence that we're in right now. Nemi, no! Don't punch. No, you punching fucker! Did you know that there are a couple of Resident Evil mods that have Pyramid Head in it? I'll probably never play any of them, because the only ones I know that he's in are, like, incredibly hard. What if the game... Wait, what if this mod ends with us doing a one-on-one street tournament with Birkin? I was gonna say Nemesis, but apparently Birkin's here. Wait, don't go that way. Goon, you fool. Birkin 1 is like the easiest thing to dodge ever. But granted, he's in a narrow hallway. Anyway, but yeah, that's why I'm excited to see your thoughts on it, because like, if you like it for whatever reason, that's great. No, it's me! No! No! Zombie me, stay away! Oh, that's what Hunk looks like, by the way. For anyone that's never seen Hunk with his helmet off. I don't want to do this, man. Give me your soul. Okay, no, we're good. Wait, does this say anything different now? Oh, I can't even inspect it. It had like a number on it earlier. I don't know what that was. What that was all about. This mod's really cool. And there's also like randomized cutscenes and stuff in here too, so we could get a different result if we played differently. There's also choices that I made that affected the outcome of what happened. For example, in this chapter, I took my helmet off at one part to get infected more quickly. Oh shit. Press the fucking thing! Okay. That's a staircase. I will- alright, Wow, my throat got incredibly dry really quick. Yeah, so the one thing I will say about Alone in the Dark, New Nightmare is a solid game. Like, it's not the best survival horror game out there, but it's, like, it stacks up against, like, the Resident Evil franchise. There's some jank in it, which prevents me from saying it's, like, it's perfect or whatever, but pretty damn good. What are my thoughts on OG Doom? I like OG Doom. I don't love it. I was never huge into it. I was more of a Wolfenstein kid. And then I played like Duke Nukem a lot as a kid too. So like I like skipped over that section of FPS history. I played a little bit of Quake, but not that much. Yeah, and then I went deep into Unreal Tournament as well. So it's more on that side of things. What are we looking at here? Oh hey, it's Final Birkin. Hey, what's up, buddy? No! Oh god. That's bad. Can I leave? Oh, I can't leave. Oh wait, there's a weapon over here. Gimme. Oh, you're in for it now. I am, however, a huge fan of New Doom. Like, Doom 2016 was really damn fun, and I am enjoying the hell out of my playthrough of Doom Eternal. He's gonna fucking murder me! Get up, Hunk! Is he dead? He's dead. Give me your loot. Alright, bye, I guess. But yeah, definitely have nothing against OG Doom. Just never clicked with me for whatever reason. Evans, wake up! What happened? You're unconscious. We can't lose more time. I'm exhausted. And I think I'll die soon. Sorry, Sherry. Oh. Do you see that button? Check out the spelling on platform and elevator there. It's our escape. Just resist a little bit more. Okay, I'm worried. Yeah, so basically we ate up the vaccine. I'll save you, and you'll have a new home very soon. Let's go. And we did that specifically because of the choice I made to make the game easier. I let myself get infected so certain enemies wouldn't attack me earlier on in this chapter. And as a result, I wasn't able to give the vaccine to Sherry because when I found it, my guy was like, oh shit. I gotta use this. Oh, this is backwards, right? We gotta go to the platform elevator. Emergency. Emergency. Oh, never mind. Platform is spelled correctly. It's just everything else that's text in that particular screenshot right there. This is fucking. Alyssa! Oh. I thought that you were dead. Again. I was really worried. We must move, Alyssa. I don't know how much time. The systems will stay operative. We'll stay operative, and Sherry needs help. She's getting worse. Alyssa's also infected, right? Get in the train. I'll activate it. Okay. By the way, we have no bullets unless I still have my unlimited chain gun. Evans, I won't go with you. I'm almost dead. And I'll turn into a zombie at any moment. Keep her safe. Rip Alyssa. When you see the doors open, go. Don't wait for me. Fine. I will make Umbrella pay for this. Go with Sherry. Goodbye. She's seeing her virus meter. Going way up. Where's my flippin' crossbow? What the hell, game? Nothing looks useful here. Is this the real RE2? Well, the cannon's pretty muddled up at this point, so I don't know. Oh, snap. By the way, if I die, we have to go back and do that puzzle all over again. Cool, shut up and let me go. Oh no, we got different music, right? Cool. In the RE universe. Yes. Give me a plug. Oh god, I've only got one of them. Never mind, we're good. I thought it looked like visually there was only one in there for some reason. Zombies, no! What the fuck? Oh, that was the background. Okay. Emergency mode is back connected to the power supply with temporarily activation of the train. What? Restoration of power. Oh god. Jim is the main guy in RE6 campaign. Leon, what the fuck? What the fuck do I do? Do I do this? I'm fucked. No. Hold on. It's the case with this mod's lore. I'm not redoing that. Oh my god, this guy fucking died to Birkin 2. Final Birkin. Yeah, I don't want to be like this guy. Show me the end. Holy moly, this is a lot of time to scroll through. Is he gonna die again? Okay, no. Okay, he made it this time. He's gonna blow up, isn't he? He's also not gonna know what to do. If I blow up, because like time's still going, that's actually completely fair. Oh, it's back there, right. Yeah, go across the sky bridge, run back through that side door, press the button over there, then the gates open. Okay. Shit. Go, Alyssa, go! I think we still have time. Sorry, like I said, it's been quite a while since I finished RE2. And I forgot this was a thing at all. Go, Alyssa, go! Hey! It's my time. Goodbye, dear Raccoon City. Also, nobody activated the self-destruct in this version of the lore, so I don't know how that happened. But whatever. Big switch get pushed. Sherry? Where's Sherry? She's probably transformed. Don't give me no weapons, damn it. Alright, Sherry, I'll cut the shit out of you. Come over here. She turns into, like, final Birkin. Sherry, no! Like father, like daughter. What you got for me? Alright, I'll take it. Done deal. I missed.
Ah.
Don't slap me. Sherry, it's me. Try to remember. That guy that you don't know at all. No! I guess I could just do this. Whoa, I teleported. Teleports behind you. Nothing personnel, kiddo. Sherry. I will destroy Umbrella just for you. Yep, bad ending. Well, that's probably GG's. That looks pretty much like GG's to me. What an awesome mod. Good job, Resi Evil Nemesis 30. Sorry, Res Evil Nemesis 30, whatever. That's fucking cool. I'm cold again. Time to put this back on. Is this DMCA?
I hope not.
It's got, oh shit, that's definitely, oh god. No. Okay. It's already too late, but oh shit. I guess this way, when I upload it to YouTube, I can hopefully not have to mute all of my audio. You guys can at least hear me talk. Reported, noob. Cool. Yeah, I know. Oh, I know that's a thing with this is actually my first RE2 mod that I've played. Oh, screw off, Starlight. But yeah, like a lot of RE2 mods just have DMCA music on the credits. Which is unfortunate. Yeah, what's one strike, right? One literally unremovable strike. Anyway, yeah, I had a lot of fun playing this mod. It was really fun. That's the end, I don't know. I'm like at a loss for words right now. Yeah, I might play more mods in the future. The thing I need to find a list of like mods that aren't like insane, because obviously this took me a while to get through just this, and I don't know. I know a lot of the endings are pretty, or endings, a lot of the mods are pretty difficult. Thank you for the one bit, Norman. Evans, also known as Hunk or Mr. Death, has finally escaped Raccoon City. I can turn this back on, probably. 2 hours later, the city was destroyed by an atomic bomb. He disappeared for a long time, and Umbrella didn't discover that he was still alive. 6 years later, Umbrella's main investors were murdered by a secret military group led by Evans. Most part of Umbrella's activities were stopped after this. This group was finally dissolved after Evans' alleged death. No one knows what happened to him, but in any case, he completed his revenge. That's a lot faster than the main RE protagonists have gotten shit done. Every RE game, we're gonna stop Umbrella. I guess they stopped Umbrella eventually. Like after RE5 or whatever. Or is it after 4? I don't even know. Ah, green screen. Single frame of green. What did we get? I can't get an S rank because I had saved like... I think I saved every single possible time I could have. B. Aw. Again, that's just against like normal game times, I'm pretty sure, so it doesn't even really matter anyway. Or if anything, it's just bad because it took me that long to do like 1/3 of the game. Oh shit, no, that's the 28 Days Later music. Fuck. God damn it. I think, right? Or maybe it was a rendition of it. God damn it. This is a DMCA nightmare. I'm never playing mods again. I'm kidding. I'd like to play some more mods later. But yeah, that's it for Mortal Knight. I'd even consider playing this again because it was really fun and there's a lot of randomized elements and different endings we can get. So yeah, maybe sometime. But I am more hyped for the new mod this guy's working on and his team. It's called During the Storm. If you guys like this or like Resident Evil 2 mods in general, I would highly suggest checking this out. It's not out yet, but there's a demo out. It's supposed to be coming out sometime this year. And it stars Kevin from Outbreak. And has a lot of the same elements of, like, randomized stuff, branching paths, weird stuff like that. Alright, no one needs to watch Claire push a thing here.